Hello everyone, I hope you're enjoying the Grand Tournament. There have been a ton of interesting new cards and interactions added in this expansion, and with so much ground to cover, it's good to start by covering the fundamentals. Today, we're going to look at my favorite part of this expansion, the Inspire mechanic. Before TGT, when you used your hero power, that was it. But now we have a full sequence, the hero power phase, where your hero's power's effects are fully resolved, followed by the Inspire phase, where all Inspire triggers queue and resolve in order of play on a single event. A property of sequences is that Hearthstone does not check for win, loss, or draw until the entire sequence is resolved. This means that you can turn a win or loss into a draw if the other hero dies in a later phase. One property of phases is that death processing is suspended during a phase, but after the phase, we run the death processing step, and insert a death phase if any death events occurred, resolving that before moving on. Since the death phase is also a phase, it can have another death phase after it, and so on. We can see that death processing is run after the hero power phase, but before the inspire phase. If we kill our hero using our hero power, a friendly tournament medic is not able to prevent our death. Notice the death scream that signifies our death. Now let's demonstrate that death processing is suspended inside of a phase. We can have a Spawn of Shadows trigger and mortally wound our hero, but then a tournament medic triggers and returns us to positive health. This could mean the difference between a draw and a win. A side effect of how death processing and death phases work is that minions can enter and leave play or change controllers mid-sequence, but as long as it exists before an event it would like to trigger on, it can. If we use our hero power to kill an enemy Deathlord, and its death rattle puts into play for us an Inspire minion, the minion will queue and trigger in the Inspire phase. All of the death phases required to resolve the explosive sheep deaths happen before we moved onto the Inspire phase. Conversely, we can kill our own Inspire minions, again indirectly using multiple explosive sheep and the related death phases, and only the Inspire minions that are still in play can trigger. Characters that are at 0 or less health, called mortally wounded, are still in play. They take up space, can trigger and be triggered. Everyone has seen that random negative effects like Knife Juggler avoid them, but what about Area of Effect effects? In previous patches, we have documented that all character Area of Effect would ignore mortally wounded characters, but all minion Area of Effect would overkill mortally wounded minions. But as of TGT, both kinds of Area of Effect overkill characters. Let's demonstrate this change. If we play two Abominations and an Acolyte of Pain, reduce the Acolyte of Pain's health to 1, and simultaneously kill both Abominations, each one of their Area of Effect damage will hit the Acolyte of Pain in the increasing negative amounts of health and continue to draw cards. If we play two Unstable Ghouls, a Dark Cultist, a Lightspawn, and Flamestrike all of them, the Unstable Ghouls will overkill the mortally wounded Lightspawn to minus 1 health, and finally Dark Cultist will target the Lightspawn and bring it back to health. Seeing this, you might wonder, Spawn of Shadows is an area effect damage that hits both heroes. Does it ignore or overkill mortally wounded heroes? It turns out the answer is ignore. We can prove this by using two Spawns of Shadows, followed by three tournament medics. The first Spawn of Shadows trigger mortally wounds us, the second one ignores us, then the tournament medics save us and show we got hit once, not twice. Finally, we can move on. A second property of phases is that aura updates are suspended during a phase, but after the phase, we run the aura update step, where effects of auras recalculate. We can use our hero power to kill Morgannis. By the time we reach the inspire phase, the aura update step is run, and the enemy hero is no longer immune, allowing our Spawn of Shadows to deal 4 damage to him. Currently there are 87 legendaries, so this next test is very difficult. In the Inspire phase, have Confessor Paltrus summon Mal'Ganis, and then a Spawn of Shadows trigger. We predict that your hero will not be immune yet, therefore you will take damage. If any of you out there manage to pull this off and record footage of it, we'll link to it with an annotation here. Good luck! We should also quickly note that the Aura Update step is split into Aura Update Health Attack, which is before the Death Processing step, and Aura Update Other, which is after. For more information about this, watch When Do Minions Die, starting from the timestamp linked by this annotation. A third property of phases is that phases consist of one or more events. These are sorted by order of play or the related characters, and we fully resolve each event before moving on. In the case of the Inspire phase, there is just one event. When we start resolving an event, we queue all triggers that are in play right now, and then we resolve each one sequentially. We move to the next event when its queue has been resolved. If the trigger has a condition, such as requiring your hand to be empty or requiring you to have free mechs, then we don't check the condition when we queue, we check the condition when we start resolving the trigger. This means that if we play Brave Archer, Recruiter, Brave Archer, and then use our hero power with an empty hand, all three minions queue in this order and trigger one by one. The first Brave Archer triggers as our hand is empty, but the second Brave Archer checks the condition and does not. In addition, if we have a full board and two of those minions are Colosseum Manager and Silverhand Regent played in that order, when we reach the Inspire phase, both of these minions are queued, despite the board being full for Silverhand Regent. Colosseum Manager's trigger creates an open space, and then Silverhand Regent triggers and summons a token. If it decided not to even queue because the board was full, it would not have triggered. Also, the queue is closed to new entries after being populated. If a Murloc Knight summons another Murloc Knight, the second Murloc Knight has missed the queue and cannot trigger. Now, let's talk about some oddities. First, you should know that destroy effects, such as Void Crusher's effect, are not instant, but set the pending destroy flag, which will be checked during the next death processing step. This means that if one of your Void Crushers hits the other, it is still in play, and it can itself trigger just fine until it suddenly drops dead. Now here's the weird part. You'd think that since Knife Jugglers ignore zero health minions, Void Crusher would ignore pending destroy minions. But as you can see in this clip, it hits them just fine. This is not a Void Crusher bug, but a bug related to all pending destroy effects. For example, if you have Arcane Missiles and Acid Maw on the board, each missile can deal damage to minions hit by Acid Maw's pending destroy, even though they ignore zero health minions just fine. Second, we can have some fun with Colosseum Manager and Silverhand Regent. When a minion attempts to move to a zone that is full, it instantly dies and moves to the graveyard instead, freeing up space. However, its death event is correctly resolved in the next death phase, not immediately. Let's demonstrate this. We'll use the same setup as before, but this time our hand will be full, and we'll cast Soul of the Forest on the Colosseum Manager. When we trigger our hero power, first the Colosseum Manager tries to enter our hand but cannot, so instantly goes to the graveyard. Then, Silverhand Regent triggers and summons a token. Notice the Soul of the Forest Death Rattle did not trigger immediately, and now there is no room for the Treant. Finally, we talked before about how all triggers queue no matter what, and only check their condition at the time of resolving. This is not 100% true, and to find out the exceptions, click the annotation on the left. If you just want to watch another Hearthstone Science video, click the video on the right. We'll cover more of the Grand Tournament cards and interactions in future videos. Thanks for watching!